Hello, what is up guys? Eman from Peso Smart Page here. Welcome to a new episode. Shout out to all the podcast listeners as well. I appreciate you all. Today, let's talk about saving. Last night, I saw this promoted video of Chinky Tan showcasing his Iponario box or just simply the Ipon box. If you already purchased it and it's helping you save some money, then more power to that. Continue doing it. Consistency is the key. Also, side note, this video is probably not for you if you already bought the product. However, if you're a skeptic like me, then please do continue watching or listening. So this is the item. So this is Ipon box. So buy one get one promo price, 99 pesos. And if you're a new customer, it just sells for 24 pesos each. And currently, it sold around 132,700 items or products. Our first question is, who really benefits from this product? So number one, is it the buyer? Because he or she or they will finally be able to save up some money. Is this really necessary? Is this product so groundbreaking that it will easily change your spending habits? So let's be honest, this product is not anything special. It's a cardboard box with some graphics on it. I'd wager that the cost of producing one item is ranging from 5 pesos to 10 pesos more or less. The color of the item is also marketed to be appealing to customers, so it's color red. The color red is associated with excitement, passion, danger, energy, or action. It usually creates a sense of urgency towards the consumers, thus making them act. So, example, buying the product. And then, just a side note, when there's a sense of urgency when it comes to investment opportunities, business opportunities, partnership opportunities, job opportunities, or even in stores, when they're promoting discounted items up to 90% off, buy it now or lose the chance of a lifetime, we all know that they'll have the same promotion next month. So shout out Shopee and Lazada. So if there's a sense of urgency for any of that, run for the closest door or window. If someone says that you should buy something now because prices will go up next week or next month or even next year, this is an automatic red flag. So we often overestimate our abilities to forecast or predict the future. No one can with 100% reliability, even if it's scientists, economists, or financial experts. So grab the opportunity now or it goes away. It doesn't really work that way. A sound investment vehicle doesn't work that way. And then this brings us to the real winner, which is of course Mr. Chinky Tan. The Ipon box sells for 99 pesos. So let's say it's buy one, get one for free. But previously, I don't think they have this kind of promotion. And then 24 pesos again for new customers. If this item, well, this item has been bought around 132,700 times on TikTok. This is just on TikTok. So I believe they also sell it on Lazada and Shopee. So if we multiply that to 99 pesos, which is the normal selling price, the gross revenue would be sitting at 13,137,300 pesos. So let's say the margin is around 50%. So the net profit or net income is at 6,568,650 pesos. So that is a lot of money. However, if you remember earlier, I said that my estimated cost per item is within the range of 5 to 10 pesos. So if you take 10 pesos as the cost of producing one item, then that brings the margin up to around 90%, which will then net around 11,823,570 pesos. And for a more modest computation, let's just take the 24 pesos selling price and compute the revenue and profit margin. For the lower selling price, the gross revenue will be at 3,184,800 pesos, and a 50% margin will net around 1,592,400 pesos. So even if it's selling at just 24 pesos, it still makes a ton of money. So this can be deemed as a very simplistic approach in calculating the gross revenue, profit margin, and net income, because there are a lot of overhead costs other than the cost of producing the product. So, for example, marketing, sales, logistics, you name it. But a 50% margin or more is pretty standard for an item like this. And now, our second question is, how and why does this work? In general, people are more likely to take action when money is involved, and it goes both ways. First example, if you're a sales rep and you get a month salary bonus if you hit the quota for the quarter, more often than not, you'll grind every day, every single day, to meet that quarterly quota, because your aim is to get the additional bonus. And then the second example is, if you already paid for a course, let's say programming and coding, worth 15,000 pesos, and after a couple of lessons, you found that it was dull and uninteresting. Since you already paid for the 15K, you will drag yourself to the finish line to take your money's worth. This is a classic example of the sunk cost fallacy. So you won't be able to recover the 15K you paid at the start of the course, whether you finish it or not. So the book, The Art of Thinking Clearly. Okay, there was a delay. I'm sorry about that. The book, The Art of Thinking Clearly by Rolf Dobelli. So I'm reading it currently. It summarizes the sunk cost fallacy best. So he said that the sunk cost fallacy is most dangerous when we have invested a lot of time, money, energy, or love in something. This investment becomes a reason to carry on, even if we are dealing with a lost cause. So probably some couple more examples would be like a relationship that has been very toxic for quite a long time, but the couple are both like fighting for it or just staying with each other because nanghihinaing sila. They're saying that, hey, we already invested 10 years on this relationship, so we gotta make it work somehow. But again, it's sunk cost fallacy. The sunk cost fallacy affects our psyche whenever we buy something. So we tend to use the overpriced impulse buy shoes from time to time, even though it's uncomfortable. Which is why the Ipon box works. So we'll say, I've already spent 99 pesos or 24 pesos for this Ipon box. Sayang naman or nakapanghinayang naman if I don't complete the Ipon challenge. And when you think about it, 99 pesos is a trivial amount compared to the 60k savings goal, kasi yung savings goal ng Ipon box. So 99 pesos is just 0.165% of 60,000 pesos. But still, it kind of works. Even if you tell the buyers that they'll save an automatic 99 pesos or 24 pesos by not buying the product and just saving the money, which will actually give them a head start in comparison to the people who bought the item. See, you don't really need that tool, that box, to save up. Most of our bank accounts have online apps and we can access it through by using the internet through a browser. So what's the point of like withdrawing your money and then putting it in a box? I mean, what if there's like a fire and then your cash, your bills, your 20 peso bills, 50 peso bills, 1,000 peso bills gets burnt? Then it's gonna be a disaster. And lastly, I saw that there's a box at the bottom left corner where you can indicate the reason for your savings. So this can be a down payment for a car, down payment for a house, or for example a motorcycle. So it can be for the latest gadget like the newly released iPhone 15 or the new Series 9 Apple Watch. But in reality, you don't really need a specific reason to save. What's more important than the reason is the habit of saving. So Morgan Housel, the author of The Psychology of Money, he stated that you can save just for the sake of saving. And indeed you should. Everyone should. When I first read this about a couple of weeks ago, my first thought was, this is ridiculous. You need to have a reason for your savings, right? But upon further reflection, I found out that I actually do this unconsciously. It's probably because I love maximizing my savings and in turn maximizing my investing and investments as well. So I started saving back in 2017. That was the time that I got my first job out of college. I was probably saving around 30% of my income back then. And then when I got the promotion a year later in 2018, it got bumped to around 40% to 50%. So as my income increased, my lifestyle and spending habits stayed the same. And this actually benefited me because I had a ton of savings when the market crashed in March 2020. So that's when the COVID pandemic started, or when it was officially announced that there was a pandemic. So I was able to capitalize on the low stock prices and scooped up ridiculously undervalued assets, just because I saved most of my money instead of spending it. Personally, I don't really like spending my money. I mean, like currently, I just spend my money on course bills, which is pretty obvious. You have to pay your bills. And then mostly books, new books, and then protein supplement, because I started working out earlier this year and I'm trying to be consistent on that as well. You gotta hit your protein goals. And then I digress, so let's get back on track. And returning to The Psychology of Money, Morgan elaborated further that savings without a spending goal gives you options and flexibility. So similar to what I had back in 2020. The ability to wait and the opportunity to pounce. So I was able to pounce on the opportunity back in 2020 when like all the stocks, all the cryptos were down. It gives you time to think and it lets you change course on your own terms. So of course, this is not really applicable to everyone because we all have unique circumstances. We all have different needs, different wants, different career paths, different family dynamics, different incomes, different expenses, and different goals, all of which affects how much we spend, save, and invest. So for example, if you're currently living paycheck to paycheck, the most reasonable way to increase or have savings is to increase your income. However, the most powerful one would be to raise your humility, especially if you have high income but little to no savings. So that really doesn't make any sense. Savings can be created by spending less. And you can spend less if you desire or want less. And you will desire less if you care less about what other people think of you or think about you. Stop keeping up with the Joneses and get off the hedonic treadmill. And with that, our episode today comes at an end. I hope that you enjoyed this episode as much as I did. Click the subscribe button for more content like this and make sure to smash the like button. Thanks again for watching and listening, everyone. Stay safe. I'll see you on the next episode. Always remember, be PESO smart.